हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक अगेन फॉर द लेक्चर्स ऑफ गणित प्रावीण्य. टुडे ऑनवर्ड्स वी आर गोइंग टू रिस्टार्ट अगेन गणित प्रावीण्य. आवर शेड्यूल ऑफ आवर एग्जाम विल बी एक्सपेक्टेड इन सम डेज. ओके, सो बिफोर दिस एग्जाम, बिफोर आवर समेटिव एग्जाम, वी हैड कंप्लीटेड आवर थ्री चैप्टर्स. दे वर क्वाइट बिग. ओके, आफ्टर दिस नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द नेक्स्ट चैप्टर, दैट इज वल्गार फ्रैक्शन, और सिंपली वी कैन से फ्रैक्शन. डोंट थिंक अबाउट दैट वर्ड वल्गार. ओके, फ्रैक्शन इन आवर रेगुलर मैथ्स वी हैव लर्न अबाउट द फ्रैक्शन. फ्रैक्शंस मीन्स पार्ट ऑफ होल. ओके, देन न्यूमरेटर्स, वॉट इज न्यूमरेटर्स, वॉट इज डिनोमिनेटर्स, दैट ऑल्सो वी हैव लर्न. How to write fraction when shaded part, a figure is given and the figure is divided into some equal parts. Out of those equal parts, some parts are shaded, some parts are unshaded. So how to write a fraction or fractional number for that? We have learned everything. Okay. For example, see here. So when we write 5 out upon 8, we read this 5/8. Correct. So what is this 5? 5 is numerator. 8 is denominator. In another language, we can say this 5, this denominator indicates total parts, whereas numerator indicates the shaded parts. Okay, so 5 parts out of 8. Understood? This is the meaning of this fraction. Okay, this we have learned. Now, we are going to solve exercise 7. Exercise 7. Before that, see, now I'm not going to write instructions here because they are very lengthy and they are taking a lot of time. So what you have to do, I have given you Xerox of every chapter. Okay, so now open the exercise 7 in your Xerox. Means I have given Xerox of this book. So open that open exercise 7 and refer those instructions before starting to watch this video. Open that Xerox exercise 7, everyone. This is compulsory. Okay, otherwise you will not come to know instructions. Understood? And while writing in the notebook, not need to write that instruction, just write this whatever I'm writing here on the board. Understood? So now pause this video and open that Xerox. Okay. See, now in exercise 7, first instruction is, this first instruction is for question number 1 to 5. If 5 be added to the numerator of each of the proper fraction below, will the resulting fraction be proper or improper? Now, what is this proper fraction and improper fraction? Okay, this year we have not learned that. Last year, if you remember, we have learned types of fraction. Okay, in that we have learned what is proper fraction, what is improper fraction. Then also I will revise within 1 minute. It's very easy. Proper fraction means what? See this fraction 5/8. Here in this fraction, see its numerator is 5 and denominator is 8. If numerator is smaller and denominator is greater than numerator. Denominator is greater. Simple, very simple to keep it in mind. What is proper and improper fraction? Numerator is smaller than denominator, and denominator is greater than numerator. This fraction is called proper fraction. This fraction is called proper fraction, whereas improper fraction is opposite of that. What it will be? Suppose it is like this, 8/5. In this case, numerator is greater. Numerator is greater and denominator is smaller, right? Numerator is greater and denominator is smaller than numerator. So this fraction is called improper fraction. And this fraction is called proper fraction. One, you if you keep it in mind, one, then another, it's very easy to understand. Proper fraction, see, once again I revise. Proper fraction means what? Numerator is smaller, the number which is above, it is smaller, and denominator is greater. That's it. This is called proper. And improper means numerator is greater than the denominator. Okay, will you keep this in mind? If you want, you can write this for your short note. Okay, now, so see here, all fractions given here are which kind of fraction? They are proper fraction. See here, 29 upon 32 means 29 is smaller, that means it is proper fraction. 8 upon 15, 8 is smaller than 15, numerator is smaller than denominator, so it is proper fraction. 70 upon 73, 10 upon 16, 9 upon 15. So in all these fractions, numerator is smaller than the denominator, so they are proper fraction. Now what is the instruction? If 5 be added to the numerator, if we add 5 in the each of the numerator, then resulting fraction means after adding 5 in the numerator, the new fraction we will get. What kind of fraction it will be? Whether it will be proper, or it will remain proper, or it will change into improper? Let's see. We have to add 5 in the numerator only in the numerator. According to the instruction, we have to add 5 in the numerator. Okay, so 29 plus 5, what you will get? 29 plus 5, 34. Denominator as it is. Okay, so 34, now it is 34 upon 32. Here in the original fraction, 29 was the numerator which was smaller than denominator, so it was proper fraction. But now there is new, after adding 5 in the numerator, we have new numerator 34, and it is greater than denominator. So is it now proper fraction, or it has changed into improper? Yes, it is improper. Now it is improper fraction. Okay, same for this. Let's add 5 in the numerator, what we will get? 8 plus 5, 13 upon 15. Okay, 8 plus 5, 13, and the denominator as it is. So now see this, here 8 was smaller than 15, means numerator was smaller than denominator, it was proper. Now after adding 5 in the numerator, we got new numerator 13, and 13 is also smaller than 15. That means it is again proper fraction only. After adding 5 in the numerator, the new fraction which we have obtained, it is also proper fraction. Okay, and see here, 70 upon 73, let's add 5 in the numerator, we will get 70 plus 5 75 upon 73. Now this numerator, new numerator, see, it is greater than denominator. Here 70 was less than denominator, 73. Now it is greater than denominator, that means it is not now proper, it has become now improper. Understood. So in this way, this fourth one and fifth one you have to solve by yourself. Immediately solve that, it's very easy. Okay, then see 6 to 10, question number 6 to 10, there is separate instruction for question number 6 to 10. What is that? See, if you can see in your paper, your Xerox, if 3 be added to the denominator of each of these improper fraction below, will the resulting fraction be proper or improper? Now what we have, here we added 5 in the numerator. Now what this instruction tell us, if we add 3 in the denominator, here denominator, then the resulting fraction will be improper or proper. Now if you observe all these 5 fractions, they are which kind of fraction? They are improper fraction, because see, this numerator is greater than denominator. here numerator was smaller than denominator. Okay, so that they were proper fraction. Here numerator is greater than denominator, that means they are improper fraction. See in all these five fractions, numerator is greater. See na, 80, 79, 80 is greater, 19, 17, 19 is greater. That means they are improper fraction. Now we have to add 3 in the denominator. If we add 3 in the denominator, then new fraction we will get, which will be that numerator write as it is upon 79 plus 3 is 80, 81, 82. So now see this new fraction, 80 upon 82, 80 upon 82. Here numerator was greater than denominator, but now in the new fraction this numerator 80 is smaller than denominator. This was improper. Now here numerator is smaller, that means it changed into proper fraction. Okay. Similarly, 19 upon 17, let's add 3 in the denominator. 19 as it is, 70 plus 3, 20. Now see here, numerator was greater than denominator, but in new fraction, 19 is smaller than 20 denominator. So it has changed into now proper fraction. When numerator is smaller, it is proper fraction. Okay. Similarly here, let's add 3 in the 100. So here 105 upon 103. See now, though we have added 3 in the denominator, is there any change in the type of fraction? Here 105 is greater than 103 also. Okay, so this is improper and this is also improper because numerator is again greater only. So this remain improper fraction. Okay, in this way 9th one and 10th one you have to solve right now. Understood? Take some time, pause this video and solve that. Okay, so see now, pause this video write this in your notebook. Okay, after that we'll see next question. Question number 11. What is question number 11? See in your Xerox, that Xerox book. If 7 be added to both the numerator and the denominator of 9 upon 16. They have given fraction. This is 11th one question. Okay. 9 upon 16. And what they are telling, if 7 be added to both the numerator and denominator, if you add 7 in both the numerator and denominator, will the resulting fraction be proper or improper? So the new fraction which we will get, it will be proper or improper. So see here, 9 and 16, let's add 7 in the both numerator and denominator. 9 plus 7, 16, right? And 16 plus 7, 23. What do you think? If you are adding same number in the numerator and denominator, it will remain whatever its kind is. Now this 9 upon 16 is which kind of fraction? Numerator is smaller than denominator, that means it is proper fraction. So if we are adding same number, that means again it will remain proper only, because see now, 16 upon 23, 16 is smaller than 23, numerator is smaller than denominator, that means it is proper fraction. Okay, understood? See example number 12, it is also same. If 3 be added to the numerator as well as the denominator of 22 upon 19. So this is given fraction and we have to add 3 in the both numerator and denominator. Will the resulting fraction be proper or improper? So let's add 3 in both the numerator and denominator. what we will get? 22 plus 3 is 25 upon 19 plus 3, 22. Okay, see, 22 upon 19, this original fraction is which kind of fraction, proper or improper? Numerator is greater than denominator, that means it is improper. So as we have added same number in both numerator and denominator, so its kind will not change, it will remain as it is. Because now see here, 25 upon 22, here also in the resulting fraction, new fraction, numerator is greater than the denominator, that means it is improper fraction. Okay, question number 13. Now the question in question number 13 is depend on observations of these two questions. There is fill in the blank. See what is question number 13. From the result obtained in question number 11 and question number 12. Question number 11 and question number 12. Write the following statements, filling in the blanks to make it true. Means they have given one statement and some blanks are given. Okay, that empty places we have to fill with the proper word by observing these two results. Okay, if the dash number is dash to both the numerator and denominator of the fraction, see, if the dash number is dash to both the numerator and denominator of a fraction, the resulting fraction does dash in its dash. Okay, so what we have done here, we have added same number in the numerator and denominator in both these questions. See, we have added same number in the numerator and denominator. So here see, if the dash number, so here what you will write, if the same number in the first blank, write here same. If the same number is, what we have done, added. In the second blank, write added. To both the numerator and denominator of a fraction, the resulting fraction does, resulting fraction. 9 upon 16, it was proper fraction. Resulting fraction is also proper fraction. 22 upon 19, it was improper fraction, and a resulting fraction means new fraction is also improper. So does it changed or remain same? It remains same. That means it does not change. It does not change in its type. Okay. So here you will write it. What is there? Does is there. Okay. Here you write not changed. Does not change. Now there is in its, does not change in its type, means type is not changed. 9 upon 16 is proper, 16 upon 23 is also proper, 22 upon 19 is improper, 25 upon 22 is also improper. Okay, so does not change in its type or kind means only type. Okay, so this four blanks you have to fill with these words. Okay, once again I repeat this. If we add same number in both the numerator and denominator, the resulting fraction does not change in its kind. Resulting fraction also remains same. Understood? Same in sense kind, type. Okay, so now write this in your notebook, and this fill in the blanks write in that empty places only which is provided here. Okay, let's move towards the next question. You can pause the video and you can take rest and again continue. Okay, now see 14th question, question number 14. When I'm reading, you also have to put your finger on that instruction so that you will understand the instruction. See, if the same number is subtracted from both the numerator and denominator of a fraction, write a true statement as in question number 13 above. Okay. Now here in 13th, what we have written? Number is added. Same number is added in both the numerator and denominator. Instead of adding, if we subtract a same number, if we subtract same number from the numerator and denominator, will the result a same? Write the true statement as in question number 13. So instead of, see here, if we subtract same number from the both numerator and denominator, then also the resulting fraction will be of same kind. So this statement which is given here, if the same number is, see this statement, if the same number which you have written in the question number 13, same statement you have to write, instead of added you write there subtracted. Okay, instead of added write there subtracted. If the same number is subtracted to both the numerator and denominator of a fraction, the resulting fraction does not change. Again, there also it will not change, okay, in its kind or in its type. Okay, then see next instruction. Next instruction, see here, there is, it is there only 5.8, starting with the 5.8. 5 upon 8 means 5/8 parts. Means when we write, see, 5 upon 8 means 5 parts out of 8, or simply to say 5/8 parts. Means what? 5 parts out of 8 equal parts, total 8 equal parts. Okay. So we can write the fraction 5 upon 8. 5 upon 8 can be written as 5 into, see this 5 in the numerator we have taken separate, 5 into 8 in the denominator as it is, and in the numerator here 5 we have taken separately, that means in the numerator what will remain? 1. 5 ones are 5. See, 5 multiplied by 1, 5 ones are 5. So 5 into 1 by 8 is equal to 5 upon 8. Same. That means what, you know, 5 upon 8 can be written as 5 into 1 by 8. Understood? This 5 upon 8 and 5 into 1 by 8, it is same. It is same because there is multiplication. Well, later when we will learn the multiplication of fraction, you will come to know that. But see now, when there is multiplication, we multiply numerator and numerator. So 5 into 1, 5, 5 ones are 5, and 8 as it is. Understood? Because when we write only number, see, when we write only number 5, it has denominator 1. Every natural number has denominator 1. Where any number, if you take 105, it has denominator 1. Okay. Similarly here, there is 5 means 5 upon 1. So 5 is numerator, here 1 is numerator. So 5 ones are 5. Here 1 is denominator, 8 is numerator. 8 ones are 8. Okay. So 5 upon 8 is same as 5 into 1 upon 8. Using this, see, okay, taking this meaning into consideration, see next instruction, taking this meaning into consideration, solve, fill in the boxes in the following questions from question number 15 to 18. Turn next page. Question number 15 to 18 are based on this meaning. I'm writing here only, see, question number 15. 4 upon 7. You can solve this into in the book only, not need to write separately. Question number 16. 3 upon 10 is equal to 3 into dash upon box 17. 12 upon 7 is equal to box into 1 by 7. And 18, 9 into 1 by 4 is equal to dash upon dash. Now see here, if you take this meaning, phi upon 8 is equal to 5 into 1 by 8, then here see 4 upon 7 is equal to dash into 1 by 7. What will come in this box? If you see this, observe this and solve this. 4 upon 7 is equal to dash into 1 upon 7. What will come here? This 4. 4 into 1 by 7. Similarly, 3 upon 10 is equal to 3 into dash upon dash. Now the, here they had given box here, they, 3 they have given here. Okay? 3 is given here. Then what will come in these two boxes? This denominator will come here and here in the numerator 1. 1 upon 10. Okay? 12 upon 7 is equal to dash into 1 by 7. What will come in the box? 12. Then 9 into 1 by 4 is equal to dash upon dash. 9 into 1 by 4 means 9 upon 4. Okay? Write this. Pause this video and write in your notebook. Now, next two questions which we are going to solve, they are very important. There are another types of fraction also. I will explain you. Don't worry. See, question number 19. Let me write first questions till that you take rest. They have given 21 only there again, so you do that changes, there is 21 22, okay, and 23rd you will solve afterwards. Now see the instructions for these questions. What is instruction? Pay attention very carefully. Convert the improper fractions in question number 19 to 23 into mixed fraction. So they have given here improper fraction. Now improper fraction means what? We have learned that when numerator is greater than the denominator, they are called improper fraction. See here, numerator is greater than the denominator, 11 is greater than 10, 38 is greater than 15, 107 is greater than 27. We have learned that. Now this improper fraction we have to convert. Convert means change. We have to change into mixed fraction. Now mixed fraction, if you remember, we have learned last year. But see here, mixed fraction means what? Mixed fraction means what? Some part of the fraction. I will show. Suppose this is one pizza and whole pizza is shaded. This is one pizza. It is also whole pizza is shaded. This is third one pizza and it is divided into four parts. Okay, and out of four parts, one part is shaded. Now if we have to write fractions for this, represent these figures in the form of fraction. So see, there is one girl, we can say her name is Siddhi. Siddhi ate this much pizzas. Siddhi ate this much pizzas, whatever are given on this board. Then if we want to tell how much pizzas Siddhi ate, then how can we say? What? Means shaded part. Shaded, whatever parts are shaded, that much pizzas Siddhi ate. So how can we write? See here, this first pizza she ate whole, complete pizza. Again, second one also pizza she ate completely, whole. WHOLE whole. Okay. So two complete pizzas she has eaten. Again she ordered third one pizza. She likes so much. So she ordered third one pizza. But third one pizza she did not eat completely. Pizza was cut into four equal parts, but out of four equal parts she ate only one. So how to represent this in the form of fraction? She ate two complete pizzas, so two whole. And third one pizza means this one complete. So this one plus one, two. And third one pizza she ate out of four equal parts, she ate only one. So 1/4. This is mixed fraction. Okay, so 2 whole, 1/4. How to read it? 2 whole. 2 whole, WHOLE whole, 1/4. Okay, that means 2 complete pizzas she ate and third one pizza, this is fractional part. Third one pizza she ate one part out of 4, that is 1/4. She ate 1/4 pizzas in the third. So, 2 whole and the 1/4. Understood? This is called mixed fraction. Means there is complete also and some fractional part. This is whole part and this is fractional part. Okay? So there is whole also and fractional also. Means there is complete also and parts also. So it is called mixed fraction. Okay? Understood? Mixed fraction means what? So now these are improper fraction. That improper fraction we can convert into mixed fraction. Improper fraction we can convert into mixed, we can change into mixed fraction. So how to change that? It is very easy. Pay proper attention. Once you understand it, you can solve easily. Okay. 17/19. First, understand why it is improper, because numerator is greater than the denominator. Numerator is greater, so it is improper. Okay. How to convert into mixed fraction? It's very easy to convert into mixed fraction. What? Take numerator and divide numerator by denominator. Means 17 divided by 15. You know how to divide? Let's divide 17 by 15. Is there 17 in table of 15? No. 15 smaller number than 17 is 15 itself. So 15 ones are 15. 7 minus 5, 2. 1 minus 1, 0. Okay, done division. Now in this division, what is quotient? 1. So whatever is quotient, that is our whole part. We have seen, no, here 2 whole, 1/4. So here in this, mixed fraction means whole part and fractional part. So what to write at the place of whole and what to write at the place of fraction? So here in this division, whatever quotient we have obtained, that is 1, it is our whole part. Okay, so 1 right here, 1 whole. What is this 2? Remainder. Remainder will be your numerator in the fractional part, and this denominator means this divisor will be your denominator. Okay, so 17/15, it was improper fraction. When we converted it into mixed fraction, we got 1/2/15. 1/2/15. Understood? So if you see here also in the improper fraction, denominator is 15 and here also denominator is 15. Quotient right here, remainder right in the numerator. Okay, so this is mixed fraction. 17 divided by 15 is equal to 15 ones are 15 and remainder is 2. So this quotient right as a whole part, remainder right of, and in the denominator again divisor. This is our answer. This is mixed fraction for this improper fraction. Okay, see, same again here, 11/10. This is improper fraction. Let's convert it into mixed fraction. 11 11 upon 10 means 11 divided by 10. So 11 right here and 10 here. 11 divided by 10. So if you divide 11 upon 10, 11 by 10, see 10 ones are 10. 11 minus 10, 1 minus 0, 1, 1 minus 1, 0. Finish. Quotient write as a whole part, that is one whole. This remainder write in the numerator and in the denominator again 10. One whole, 1 by 10. Okay. Next. 38 upon 15. This is improper fraction. Let's convert it into mixed fraction. So 38 upon 15 means 38 divided by 15. Now see here, 38 divided by 15. 15 ones are 15, 15 twos are 30. So see here, 15 twos are 30. 30 is a smaller number than 38, which is in table of 15. 8 minus 0, 8. 3 minus 3, 0. Okay? Finish. So 2 is our quotient, so 2 will be our whole part. 2 whole. Remainder is 8. 8 upon 15. Okay? See this, 107 upon 27. That is 107 divided by 27. Okay? If you don't know table of 27, approximately we can check. 27 5s are 135. No. 27 4s are 108. See, 27 4s are 108. We cannot take that because 108 is greater than 107. Okay, so we have to take 27 threes are, and 20, what is 27 threes are? 81. Seven minus 1, 6, and 10 minus 8, 2. 26 is remainder. How we can see, get sure that our remainder is correct? Remember that remainder is always less than this divisor, okay? So now let's write the in the form of mixed fraction. 3 is quotient, so 3 whole. Remainder is 26 upon divisor is 27. That will be your denominator. Okay. So 3 whole, 3 whole, 26 upon 27. So in this way, we can convert improper fraction into mixed fraction. Opposite of that, if mixed fractions are given, that we can reverse into improper fraction. We can convert mixed fraction also into again improper fraction. So that is in the next question. So now pause this video. In this question, the question number 23, you have to solve by yourself. Okay, now pause this video. After that, we will see next. Okay. The next instruction is opposite of that. Mixed fractions are given and we have to convert them into improper fraction. They are also very easy to understand. See, question number 24. 8 whole, 5 upon 7. Question number 25th. 5 whole, 2 upon 15. 26, 37 whole, 1 upon 3. And 27th, 11 whole, 5 upon 16. Okay, means they are mixed fraction. See how to read mixed fraction. 8 whole, 5 upon 7. You know meaning of this? Siddhi ate complete 8 pizzas. Siddhi has eaten complete 8 pizzas, and 9th one pizzas was cut into 7 equal parts, and out of 7 equal parts she ate 5 parts. So this is meaning of this mixed fraction. Okay, 8 whole, 5 upon 7, 5 whole, 2 upon 15, in this way. Now these are mixed fraction. How to convert them into improper fraction? It's very interesting and easy. See, what to do. This take 8 here, multiply with the 7. 8 multiplied by 7, which is denominator. Whole part multiplied with the denominator, and this numerator, you know, add in the in this multiplication. Upon this denominator, write as it is 7. What we have done, understood? See once again. Whole part, that is 8, multiplied with the denominator, and in that we have added this numerator 5. If you remember the verification rule of in the division, quotient into divisor plus remainder. Okay, this so in the previous question when we solve, when we converted improper fraction into mixed fraction, we got this whole part. It was what? Quotient. This denominator means it was divisor, and this numerator means it was remainder. So quotient into divisor plus remainder. This is nothing but verification rule of the division. Dividend is equal to quotient into divisor plus remainder. Okay. Here, for keeping in mind, just see here, whole part multiplied with the denominator plus numerator upon this denominator again here. Okay. Is equal to, see, 8 sevens are 56 plus 5 upon 7. And 56 plus 5, 61 upon 7. This is our improper fraction, 61 upon 7. You can check by converting this improper fraction to again mixed fraction. You will get this. 61 upon 7 means 61 divided by 7. If you divide 61 by 7, what you will get? 7, 8 is a 56. And 61 minus 56, you will get 5. So, 8 whole 5 upon this 7 here. Understood? Next, 5 whole 2 upon 15. So, how we have to do whole part? 5 into denominator 15 plus this numerator upon 15. Don't forget to take this again upon here 15. Okay? Is equal to 15 fives are 75 plus 2 upon 15. 75 plus 2, 77 upon 15. Next, 37 into 3, 37 whole, so 37 into 3 plus numerator 1 upon 3. Okay, is equal to 37 threes are what? 3 sevens are 21. 1 will come down, 2 will be carried. 3 threes are 9 plus 2, 11. Okay, plus 1 upon 3. So 111 plus 1, 112 upon 3 is the expected improper fraction, improper fraction for this mixed fraction. Next, here see whole part is 11 into 16, denominator this way, plus 5 upon 16, again this denominator. Okay, now 11, 16 into 11, 16 ones are 16, 6 will come down, 1 will be carry, 16 ones are 16 and 1, 17 plus 5 upon 16. 176 plus 5. What you will get? 181. Correct? Upon 16. So this is the expected improper fraction for this mixed fraction. Understood how to convert improper fraction into mixed fraction and how to convert mixed fraction again into improper fraction? Practice both. This is very important. The question can be asked on this. So practice this. Understood? Write this in your notebook. The 28th one question. Solve by yourself. Practice by yourself. Okay? So thank you and have a nice day.